Even though things are getting icy in the Windy City, you are looking at live pictures of busy Michigan Avenue. Well, a light freezing drizzle is falling, so watch out. Now in the west, a wind has been falling and it's a big problem. It's been blowing. We have seen some pretty impressive gusts. Now some trees and power lines are down. Now one tree did smash into a house, splitting it right down the middle.
And strap yourselves in. Tomorrow is going to be a rough one for the eastern half of the country. Severe thunderstorms will produce tornadoes. In the Midwest, wind and snow, blizzard-like conditions, and dangerously cold wind chills. And in the Northeast, it's ice and rain.
Hello, and welcome to Weather Center. I'm Lisa Mozer.
And I'm Dave Schwartz. Well, the weather is going to take us on a roller coaster ride this weekend. We begin tonight with our winter weather expert, Paul Kocin. Paul?
Well, a jolt of bitterly cold air moving through the northern plains is really going to change the scene across much of the Midwest. As a storm system developing now across Nebraska moves across the Midwest and behind it, that's where we're going to see some rapidly falling temperatures, some blowing snow, and wind chills that are going to go well below zero. Let's take a look at the forecast conditions as of tomorrow morning. Low pressure is going to be in northern Missouri at this time. That's going to be moving towards the northeast. Meanwhile, most of the rain is going to be occurring in the eastern U.S., although it looks like along the northern fringes of that, that's where we'll be seeing some freezing rain from the suburbs of Washington, D.C. through Detroit and other places. But it's this mass of cold air behind the cold front that's really going to change conditions for the worse across much of the plain states during the day. As we go during the day, we'll see the low pressure system move up towards the northeast. Very strong cold front will push down towards the Gulf Coast, and that secondary push of cold air will be all the way down into the southern plain states. Now, as it does so, we will see an area of light snows breaking out with the cold air across Missouri into Illinois, and that snow will be accompanied by rapidly falling temperatures and winds that will be gusting from 20 to 30, if not more, 40 miles per hour, and falling temperatures, creating near blizzard conditions. So as we get late in the day, we're going to start seeing that bitterly cold air really surge down towards the central United States. Now, as we're going from Saturday night into Sunday, the low pressure system moves up across Michigan, and then we're going to see the cold air now really surge across the southeastern United States. And as some energy crosses the southeastern United States, we'll also see some snow showers developing behind the cold front, and we'll see strong winds and blowing snows across much of the Ohio Valley, portions of the Tennessee Valley, up to the Appalachians, and possibly even as far south as Atlanta, Georgia. Now, at that point, the surface high pressure center will be drifting quite far to the south, but we'll still see a lot of that cold air really be forced southeastward towards much of the southeastern United States. So it looks like quite a big surprise is going to be occurring on Sunday across portions of the southeastern portion of the country. Now, as we're going to Minneapolis, where we'll have a live shot, the impact will be as follows. We'll be having some moderate snows during the night into tomorrow morning on the order of 3 to 6 inches. Not much wind in the morning, but then we'll see the winds really picking up to 20, 30 miles per hour and temperatures falling from the teens to near 0 degrees by late in the day, creating wind chills on the order of 40 degrees below zero. So very dangerous conditions there. As we head further south towards St. Louis and Kansas City, not a bad start during the day, but we have to watch out as the cold air really comes in. We might be picking up some snow, and then the winds are really going to increase as well as the cold air. And that's where we'll see the wind chills turning down towards minus 20 to minus 30 degrees. So a really tumultuous change in the weather across portions of the center of the United States. It's going to be moving towards the southeast and east coast as we get towards Sunday. Let's turn it back to Dave.
Well, winter weather expert Paul Kocin, sounds like you are going to be busy around here keeping a close eye on this storm. It's important to note that residents of Chicago and Milwaukee who were hit hard by the last snowstorm will not see anything on the order of the 12 to 16 inches of snow that you got last week. It'll just be windy and cold with blowing snow. Now, the coldest air is north of this frontal boundary, and it's being slung southward in the wake of this area of low pressure. As that moves eastward, the cold air will just be unleashed, and it'll really be felt here in the plains, the Front Range, back into the Great Lakes states, and into the southeast. The last of us to feel the cold air will be New Yorkers, for example. The cold air really is not going to get here, and when it does, it'll be in a much modified form. Right now, the wind chills, well, you can see where the Arctic blast is with a wind 11 below, cold front just through Rapid City, but it's been through Billings for a while. And up in Glasgow, 60 below is the wind chill outside. So it's dangerous cold that's heading southward, and it is the wind that really makes it extra dangerous. The big swirl is beginning to happen. One piece of energy heading this way, another little disturbance heading this way through Kansas. As that heads eastward, the threat of severe weather here tonight, Lisa will get into that in a minute. And another, the last one, the big one, headed through Wyoming into Colorado, where the snow continues to fly. Here in Chicago and Detroit, Mother Nature's, oh, she's kind of given us a little nickel and dime action, but it's not the kind of weather that you like to see. This is all rain. It's beginning to lighten up now in Chicago, but this is what it looks like right now outside downtown. This is Michigan Avenue in Chicago. We've had light rain. As you can see, the flags are unfurled down there. It is windy. It's cold. Temperature is in the upper 20s, and that's freezing rain. So out in the suburbs where roads go over air, for example, bridges, overpasses, it is icy out there right now. 27 at Des Plaines at O'Hare, 27 in Aurora, where it was below zero this morning, so you better believe the ground is cold. Here in Chicago's lakefront right there, it's 30 degrees. That's the warmest spot we can find. Temperatures will remain between 28 and 32 degrees for the rest of tonight. And there's more rain heading northward. That's headed toward Detroit. Right now, we've got a little bit of light rain right now. Temperature here, also 27 degrees. So it's not very pleasant around the Midwest at the present time. Meanwhile, in St. Louis, we're getting southeasterly winds. Temperatures will actually rise tonight to the low 30s in the morning. And then with the approach of the cold front by afternoon, fall to 21 by afternoon with a wind chill below zero. That big storm is on the way. Lisa.
And big it is, Dave. Saturday looks to be a very stormy day in parts of the South as well. Our severe weather expert, Dr. Greg Forbes, he has been keeping a close eye on this situation and has more to tell us overnight tonight and through the day Saturday. Greg?
A very strong winter system is going to bring warm air north from the Gulf of Mexico. That means that beginning tonight, there could be the possibility of hail and damaging winds and then tornadoes tomorrow. That warm air will flow northward off the Gulf of Mexico ahead of this strong low-pressure system. Everywhere tomorrow morning except the Appalachian Mountain areas will have warm air in place at the surface. That'll mean the possibility of hail and high winds overnight tonight from Louisiana across Mississippi and Alabama. During the day tomorrow, that low-pressure system and cold front push east, and the severe weather moves with it, developing the possibility of tornadoes, especially across the center part of this red area, Birmingham, Alabama, Montgomery, Alabama, central Georgia into the Carolinas. Even some hail as far north as Kentucky and high winds as well all the way to the coast of the Carolinas. Now let's go back to the studio.
Well, as we said, conditions are looking a little bleak, especially as we go into the next 24-hour period. But for some of us across the Carolinas, it wasn't a terribly bad day. We didn't have any sun, but we were looking at overcast conditions with little, if any, precipitation. We do have a few sprinkles of rain in and around the Charlotte area. Fog has been a problem across many areas of the southeast, and it's beginning to spread around Louisiana, the Red River Valley of Texas into Oklahoma. Visibility reports now below 1 mile, and we're likely to see even more of this fog overnight tonight and through tomorrow morning. So drive slow and remember the low beams do work best. Seeing a few light wrinkles of precipitation push through Fayetteville, North Carolina. Spartanburg also seeing a few spritz of rain right now. We've had a few thunderstorms to break out. South Atlanta getting hit pretty good right now, so watch out Jonesboro. Eventually, it does look like the thunderstorms or heavy rain showers, if they don't hold together, will push into the Athens, Georgia area, probably in the next hour. Taking a look at the big picture, again, we have a lot of fog, and that's because we have cooler air along the surface, warmer, moister air aloft, and of course, it's a stable atmosphere for many of us, but it is tapping in a lot of that moisture, trapping that moisture in the low levels, and that's producing the fog. Looking at the temperatures right now, lots of 40s and 50s across the southeast. Houston, 53, 51 in Birmingham. Atlanta, currently looking at a temperature of 45 degrees. Visibility has not been above 3 to 4 miles across many areas of North Georgia today. 41 is the current temperature in Raleigh, North Carolina. Going further to the north, right now in New York, we have cloudy skies and a current temperature of 35 degrees. What can you expect tomorrow? Across Long Island, cloudy skies will continue, but rain will be moving in from the west. But rain, not snow. We are expecting and anticipating an icy situation further to the north where we had some sun today, but it's pretty cold now. Looking at 16 degrees in Burlington, Vermont, that cold air is going to help produce that icy situation as the moisture does move in from the west. But in the meantime, we have plenty of time to get out, run a few errands, maybe stock up a few more Christmas gifts. But as we go through the day tomorrow, especially midday and later on into the evening, things will only get worse. Taking a look further out to the west now, let's go back to Dave.
That's right, Lisa. Boy, storms are brewing everywhere, huh? Look at all these clouds streaming northeastward. At least there's some place we get a decent weekend. El Paso, Phoenix, Vegas, Los Angeles, San Diego. A little windy in the mountains north of Los Angeles, but those winds will calm down and then things look just fine. But there is another storm just off the west coast. You see the clouds there. That'll be slamming into Seattle once again. As we head west, however, we do find it is pretty quiet. Winds have been pretty strong, low pressure right in here, and a pretty tight pressure gradient back to high pressure behind the word weather in current weather here at our banner. And the winds have been extremely strong, strong enough to knock over trees and power lines. Wind damage reported in the southeast suburb of Maple Valley, this in the Seattle-Tacoma metropolitan area. What a mess. Trees were splintered like toothpicks due to strong winds. And this house was just split in half. We now have two small houses, a duplex from initially a single home. We don't need that. 43 degrees, rain, wind will not be a factor tomorrow in Seattle, and it isn't tonight, as a matter of fact. The winds have moved eastward, the strong winds, in association with this area of low pressure. Light winds right now in Seattle, but further east, winds are gusting to 50 miles an hour, taking our temperature in Rapid City 26 down to 11 below. Wind chill Glasgow 60 below. Lisa Mozer.
Let's take a look at all the elements coming together one more time here this hour. We're looking at a jet stream. It's been favorable for allowing colder air to slide further and further southward. So when the systems do organize coming together, they push that colder air further and further southward. So watch out Houston, Texas. Watch out Shreveport, Louisiana. If you think it's a little chilly now, just wait, because as the saying goes, you ain't seen nothing yet. This too is an Arctic air mass that's pushing southward. As it does wind up here together, the low pressure area, that is, it's going to become quite a wind maker, and at times with the temperatures cold as they are, the wind, of course, is only going to worsen the situation, causing a lot of the snow to blow around, but also giving us dangerously cold wind chills that will be in the double digits below zero. Break out the extra cold weather gear if you do have to go outside, but remember, it will not be safe. As we watch these two elements come together, the wind and the snow across the Midwest for tonight, keep in mind that this will all be spreading towards the east. In the meantime, we have some rain showers and a few thunderstorms in the low Mississippi Valley area. The snow is beginning to add up across the Wasatch, and the temperatures are falling fairly quickly tonight across the panhandle of Nebraska, but not a lot of snow at this time. We are looking at maybe 2 to 6 inches, as Dave and Paul have already concurred on that, but notice that that wind is not going to be letting up throughout the day, even if the snow lets up in your area.
As you said, Lisa, you ain't seen nothing yet. Here's what it looks like in Bloomington, Minnesota.
Nobody does it like you.
The new Hoover Steamback White Path sends hot water surging through 6 rotating brushes to stir up and pull out dirt others may leave behind. If you want clean,
Hoover.
Deep down, you want Hoover.
Yeah? Alrighty. Looks like a lot more mates are coming by.
In the outback, when we have a little dinner get-together, we try to make sure it's an experience mates will go away talking about. Outback Steakhouse. No rules, just right.
Whose house was this?
I don't know.
Visit our website for the Outback Steakhouse nearest you. No rules, just right.
How important is comfort to you? A Carrier high-efficiency furnace with our exclusive comfort heat technology can keep your entire home quietly and consistently comfortable hour after hour. For about the same amount of electricity a 100-watt bulb uses. Carrier, custom-made indoor weather. Contact an indoor weather expert for reliable and efficient solutions to all your heating and cooling needs.
And it's time now for Travel Wise. I'm Lisa Mozer. As you can probably imagine, with so much weather going on, with a very active weather pattern, we're having all types of problems, not just on the roadways, but also a lot of delays due to air travel being affected. Looking at Chicago, 180-minute delay being reported there, about an hour delay being reported in St. Louis, a 45-minute delay in Atlanta, also a delay in Houston, Texas, and LaGuardia also reporting a delay. Right now in LaGuardia, it looks like poor visibility and low ceilings are a problem for you. Of course, sometimes you can have a delay and it's not even associated with the weather where you currently are. It could be a weather at a major city to the west or to the south or to the east of you. So please do keep this in mind and plan on having some delays, especially as we go through the next several days, because the problems that we are about to take part on in the Midwest are likely to affect us in a number of ways, not just transportation. We'll be looking at light snow move across Michigan and looking at Wisconsin with some light snow adding up. Some rain showers have been mixed with some freezing rain across Illinois, Indiana, and Ohio. This is expected to continue overnight tonight. Now, as you go through the day tomorrow, keep in mind that we have snow and cold to the north, but also some thunderstorms will be plaguing parts of the low Mississippi Valley area. And some of these thunderstorms could be strong, could be severe, high wind, and maybe even a tornado. So stay tuned.
Millions of people have seen the future, and now you can own it.
I've never seen anything like this before.
X-Men. With 10 minutes of never-before-seen footage. Buy it today.
Is somebody making Campbell's chicken noodle?
Yep, it's all for you.
You always knew Campbell's was good. You just didn't know how good. Because now, every soothing, comforting bowl is brimming with even more golden goodness.
Wow, look at all that chicken.
Now, Campbell's chicken noodle has more chicken than ever, so it's even more good.
I feel much better.
I'll get us some more.
Why don't we get it together?
Campbell's good.
What?
5 years ago, two eager CEOs started their own companies. One encouraged his employees to read the Wall Street Journal to stay ahead of the competition. The other did not.
All right, let's keep working. Come on, Bill.
24.
Let's join them for their 5-year anniversaries and see what happened.
You guys are incredible. These past 5 years have been amazing.
Thanks for enduring the pay cuts and the loss of benefits.
But we've been even more successful than I could have hoped.
To 5 more years of this.
Look at you!
Imagine what the Journal could do for you. It's now easier to get the Journal to help you. Get 8 weeks of the Wall Street Journal for just 37 cents a day. That's 50% off the regular rate. Call 800-942-3600. That's 800-942-3600. The Wall Street Journal. Adventures in capitalism.
Next week on Atmospheres, storm chasers capture killer tornadoes on tape. And watch hurricane hunters as they fly into the eye of a hurricane. Don't miss Atmospheres with meteorologists Jim Cantore and Mitch Michaels, Wednesdays at 8 on the Weather Channel.
How would your little Lionel engineer like to get up in the morning? Not with this. Introducing the Lionel Train 100th Anniversary Alarm Clock. It's a wonderful miniature town complete with trees, beautifully detailed buildings, and even people. When it's time to get up, the train lets you know it with authentic bells, whistles, and chugging sounds as it rumbles through the town and in and out of the tunnel that's built through the mountain. When you press the alarm off button, the train stops and greets you.
Good morning. All aboard.
What a cheerful way to start the morning. And you can enjoy the action all day long. Just press the Lionel L and the little train starts its run, complete with all the sound effects. This special Lionel 100th Anniversary collectible comes with an individually numbered certificate of authenticity. And it's yours for only $29.95. So order now.
To order your Lionel Train alarm clock, have your credit card ready and call toll-free 1-800-506-7800 or send check or money order for $29.95 plus $6.95 shipping and handling to the address on your screen.
Right now, it's your local forecast on the Weather Channel.
Thank you.
And here we are, the jet stream, taking a dip, huh? Taking a dip this time of year doesn't mean jumping into a pool because it's nice and warm. It means that cold air from Canada is taking a dip into the United States. That's why it was, what, 5 below this morning in the western suburbs of Chicago? That is cold. And we've had this jet stream pretty far to the south this early in the season. There's quite a snowpack out there. Cold air. Here's another shot of cold air on Monday into the middle of the United States. Nice and warm under the ridge. A warming trend is on tap in Palm Springs and Phoenix. Oh, perfect. Vegas, too, even into southern Utah, where we've had some windy and cold weather lately. Meanwhile, along the East Coast, you are going to be wet this weekend all the way into Monday. Here's what I'm talking about. First off, we have had to use every color in our color graphic system just to put this map together. Look at this. Snow in northern, this is an idea of how much warm air is being transported northward. The only place on the East Coast on Saturday where it will be snowing only is in northern Maine. Everywhere else, some warm air gets in. Mid-levels, low levels. At mid-levels, we end up with sleet and freezing rain. At low levels, it's just plain old rain. And that'll be the story from Boston. West on the Mass Pike, though it could be freezing rain for a little while. All of Connecticut, rain and windy as the day wears on tomorrow. Rain across Pennsylvania. And wherever we've had some recent snows, some of that snow's going to melt. Plus, we're expecting heavy rain Saturday night and Sunday, particularly into New England. So there could be some flooding, a possibility, until the cold air finally swings through and just dries us out. Then where will the next storm form? Well, it's going to drop into the trough of low pressure, spread some snow now from Cape Girardeau up to Cleveland. This looks like a relatively minor storm compared to what's going to be happening tomorrow and Sunday. This storm heads to the East Coast. Also rain from Florence, South Carolina up to Quincy, Mass. And then snow from Albany southward to Dillard, Georgia. So good news for the skiers here in the Appalachians. We need the rain in South Florida. Boy, the drought continues. Severe drought in South Florida. Lake Okeechobee is at its second lowest level ever since we've been keeping records for this time of year. So we need the rain. Unfortunately, Mother Nature is not going to be very generous to us. The cold front sweeps through, and then that is that. And then another storm may develop over the southwest, as here in the Midwest and Northeast, we get a pretty good chance of some relief from the stormy weather by week's end. Temperature-wise, well, we find our warm weather heading up to Pittsburgh, where the high temperature on Saturday will be in the upper 40s, compared to the upper teens in Omaha, and falling during the day. So we'll have warm air heading this way, cold air heading that way, and under the ridge of high pressure over the southwest, the weather looks just fine. Shirt sleeve weather as you do a little Christmas shopping at Los Arcos Mall in Scottsdale, Arizona, and the weather looks fine into Thousand Oaks, California as well. Central and South Florida, we've been in the 80s. We'll cool down to the 70s. This Arctic air is not going to make its way in there, and that means our heating oil bills will be on the low side, as opposed to what's going to be happening here in Chicago in the Twin Cities and New York City, where temperatures will be, especially here in the Midwest, where temperatures are going to be way below average for the next several days. Overnight lows in the single digits above or below zero. That's pretty much the forecast for the Twin Cities the next 5 days. So there we have it. The dip in the jet stream. No dip in the pool. It's a dip of Canadian cold southward into the lower 48. Coming up next, a live report from Mike Seidel in Minneapolis and expert analysis from Paul Kocin on this next big storm.
Cannonballs, $129 online. 88 hula hoops, $60 online. Elephant shampoo, $42 online. Not having to pay for any weird charges that show up on your bill? Priceless. With MasterCard, you're not responsible for unauthorized purchases on the web or anywhere. There are some things money can't buy. For everything else, there's MasterCard.
I just want my cold sore to go away.
Sooner.
I'm tired of medicines that just make it feel better.
Can't anybody just make it go away?
Introducing Abreva, the non-prescription medicine that shortens healing time. New Abreva starts to work right at the tingle, so you start to heal it as soon as you feel it.
It really works?
Only Abreva has docosinol and is the only non-prescription medicine approved by the FDA to shorten healing time.
I can do something real about a cold sore.
New Abreva. Start to heal it as soon as you feel it.
I like that.
What you're about to see will astound you. It's my real baby, the amazing living baby. Hold her in your arms and the magic begins. Her lifelike movements have made front page news and have even been seen on NBC's Today Show. You will be thrilled by your child's reaction to the amazing living baby. She's so real, kids can't wait to show and tell friends and classmates. My Real Baby is the new finger baby. The slightest movement of your hand and fingers makes the baby come alive. It's been called the next Tickle Me Elmo. To order, call this number. You won't find My Real Baby in stores. Give a unique and special gift that children love. Get big discounts on twins and triplets. Choose between light or dark My Real Baby today.
To order your My Real Baby for $19.99 plus shipping, have your credit card ready and call the number on your screen or send check or money order to the address shown. Sorry, no CODs.
Oh no, that new carpet is ruined. Uh-oh, that stain will never come out. Introducing Oxygen 8, the amazing cleaner powered by oxygen to eliminate tough stains and odors from virtually any material in seconds. It removes dirt, food stains, pet messes, and more. Just oxygenate it. Even tough mold and mildew is no problem for Oxygen 8. And just look how it whitens and brightens laundry. The secret is oxygen bubbles that change the chemical composition of organic stains and make them disappear forever. Watch, we poured wine, iodine, and coffee on this shirt. Then we added detergent and Oxygen 8. Look, the stain's still there. But Oxygen 8 eliminates stains instantly. Don't waste money on all these different cleaners. This competitor costs $29.85. But now you can get super concentrated Oxygen 8 for only $19.95. Call now and get the amazing Oxygen 8 Concentrated Citrus Cleaner. Eliminates grease and grime like magic. Call within the next 10 minutes and we'll send you another 1 pound free. Enough for 85 gallons of cleaner. That's an incredible value, all for only $19.95. Not available in stores. Order today.
Right now, it's your local forecast on the Weather Channel.
Lots of hustle and bustle tonight in Chicago, even though things are getting a little bit icy even at this hour in the Windy City. We are looking at pictures of the busy Michigan Avenue. A little light freezing drizzle still can be found in the area at this time.
In the west, wind has been the big problem. We've seen some pretty impressive gusts. Trees and power lines are down. One tree smashed into a house, splitting it right down the middle.
And strap yourself in. Tomorrow is going to be rough for the eastern half of the country. Severe thunderstorms could spawn tornadoes to the south. In the Midwest, a big winter storm will explode, causing blizzard-like conditions and dangerously cold wind chills. The Northeast is for ice and rain. Hello, welcome to Weather Center. I'm Lisa Mozer.
And I'm Dave Schwartz. Now, the weather is going to take us on a roller coaster ride this weekend. We begin tonight with our Mike Seidel. He joins us live from Bloomington, Minnesota. Mike, this weekend will be bone-chilling again in the Midwest, huh?
It will, Dave. This is my second weekend here at the Mall of America, just doing a little shopping, of course, on the side. And the problem will be the wind tomorrow. Not that we're going to get a lot of snow, but let me show you what we've got on the ground. We've got a couple of inches on the ground, and this is the concern. This is very dry, powdery snow. You can't make snowballs. And it blows around very, very easily. What's going to happen later tonight and tomorrow, we're going to get another several inches of snow, 2 to 3 inches maybe. Then we're going to have winds increasing, gusts to 35 to 40 miles an hour. This is going to blow everything around, so we're basically going to what we term have a ground blizzard. That doesn't necessarily mean it will be snowing, but tomorrow afternoon and tomorrow night, all this snow will be just swirling around the upper Midwest, lowering visibilities as temperatures fall. Let's show you how the temperatures will be falling. Right now in Minneapolis at the airport, it's 19 with a wind chill of 5 below zero. We'll start off at 18, but look at those winds increasing 25 to 35 miles an hour. And by 5 o'clock, we'll be down around zero. And with a 30 mile an hour wind, that will push the wind chill tomorrow by dinner time to 50 to 55 below zero here in the Twin Cities. Even colder north and west of here. So very dangerous values. Tomorrow night's lows will be between 5 and 10 below zero. The only promising news we have in the whole weekend forecast, if you don't like cold weather, well, it's going to stay cold, but the wind will really diminish by Sunday morning. So Sunday will be cold, but it will be a lot less windy. Dave will be here bundled up, and I'll be here right on through the weekend, at least through Sunday morning, to show you how cold it is. Now let's get the update on this very, very quick-moving but very intense storm from our winter weather expert, Paul Kocin. Paul?
Well, it looks like our storm system's right on schedule. I just checked some of the new model information. It still looks like a very strong storm system going to pass northward across the Great Lakes. And behind that storm, that's where we're going to get all the cold air coming down southward. And even some fairly light to significant snowfall across portions of the Ohio Valley, including Chicago, that's going to be blowing around and drifted. So it's going to be a tough go of it. Not only in Minneapolis, but through a lot of other places through the Midwest. By tomorrow morning, we're going to see a lot of cold northwesterly winds, temperatures falling to zero below, and notice how close the isobars to each other. That's going to be accompanied by very strong winds with the cold air, and the cold front is going to be dropping towards the southeast as we go through the day. So by tomorrow evening, we're going to see the original cold front in a position like that, and the secondary surge of really cold air really now poised down across the south central United States. And as that cold air comes in, we may be seeing a fairly widespread area of light snow breaking out across portions of Missouri, Illinois, Wisconsin, and northern Minnesota. And combined with that very strong northwesterly wind, the snow is obviously going to be blown around, creating very low visibilities and hazardous driving conditions, and very dangerous just to be out. As we go from Saturday night towards Sunday morning, the storm system continues to move towards the northeast, and the cold front is going to be driving far to the southeast, bringing the possibility of snow showers, strong winds, and much colder temperatures to portions of Georgia, Tennessee Valley, and even the Ohio valleys. So we'll be looking for those conditions to really go downhill across even the southern United States as we go from Saturday night to Sunday. Let's turn it back to Dave.
Thank you, our winter weather expert, Paul Kocin, along with the live report from Mike Seidel from the field. We're on top of this storm. We're keeping an eye on it as it heads out from the Rocky Mountains into the plains. This is an overview of what's going to happen tomorrow, from the snow that Paul Kocin just talked about to the severe thunderstorms, which you see shaded in red. This is the most likely area from the eastern sections of Kentucky and Tennessee, back down into Alabama, over to Georgia, Florida Panhandle too, and then right up into the eastern Carolinas. Right now, the storm is just getting together. Mother Nature's kind of nickel and diming us. The moisture's overrunning a cold polar air mass right here, and the storm will come in like this. Everything will kind of swing around. The moisture, the cold air gets wrapped in here, and that's what Saturday and Sunday is. It's going to be a total washout or a whiteout, depending on where you are. Right now, we're 11-degree wind chill in Chicago and 2-degree wind chill where Mike Seidel is. But behind the Arctic front, as you can see, it gets dangerously, dangerously cold. Here goes the merry-go-round. Our main upper-level area of low pressure is now pulling out into the western high plains, circulating some moisture northward into the Great Lakes states. We've got some light snow in Midland, Michigan at the present time, and Milwaukee, with a band of some freezing drizzle right around Chicago. It's pretty much left town. Temperatures in the upper 20s, the chance of some drizzle, otherwise just cloudy. Temperatures holding between 28 and 32 degrees for the rest of tonight. what ice there is out there in the suburbs. We'll be hanging around for the rest of tonight, too. Meanwhile, further east, a few sleet pellets and freezing drizzle here in Detroit, but there's a lot less than meets the eye. A lot of this is actually not reaching the ground. We're 28 degrees, but there are some icy spots, particularly west of town. Indianapolis, the winter weather advisory has been canceled, I'm glad to say. 32 degrees, temperatures slowly warming for the rest of tonight. St. Louis will have temperatures falling tomorrow as the cold front blasts through. 29 degrees at noon, 24 at 3 p.m., the typical time we have our high temperature, and by 5 o'clock it'll be snowing, windy, and very cold. Lisa.
Well, Dave, Mike could not make snowmen, but I'll bet you could do a real good snow angel in that snow. Well, Saturday looks to be very stormy. That same system will produce some severe weather, and our Dr. Greg Forbes has been keeping an eye on the situation to the south. Here's Greg with more.
A very strong winter system is going to bring warm air north from the Gulf of Mexico. That means that beginning tonight, there could be the possibility of hail and damaging winds, and then tornadoes tomorrow. That warm air will flow northward off the Gulf of Mexico ahead of this strong low pressure system. Everywhere tomorrow morning except the Appalachian Mountain areas will have warm air in place at the surface. That'll mean the possibility of hail and high winds overnight tonight from Louisiana across Mississippi and Alabama. During the day tomorrow, that low pressure system and cold front push east and the severe weather moves with it, developing the possibility of tornadoes, especially across the center part of this red area, Birmingham, Alabama, Montgomery, Alabama, central Georgia into the Carolinas. Even some hail as far north as Kentucky and high winds as well all the way to the coast of the Carolinas. Now let's go back to the studio.
Greg, our severe weather expert. Taking a look at the southeast now, you'll notice that the warm front pretty much in place right around the panhandle. Today around Pensacola, Florida, over to the Biloxi, Mississippi area, we've had a really tough time with fog. Visibility will continue to worsen now that we're getting into the overnight hours. Although it was a little bit better, it's going to slow you down even more along I-10 overnight tonight. Patchy dense fog has also been a problem across much of the southeast, including Shreveport, Louisiana, getting over to the Red River Valley, down towards the Dallas-Fort Worth area. Here too, overnight tonight, patchy dense fog reports likely to dip as low as a quarter of a mile. Taking a look a little further inland to the Carolinas, we've been looking at a few spritz of rain showers cross over Spartanburg, Columbia, but we had a few thunderstorms ride just to the south of the Atlanta metro area. It looks like Jonesboro, and now we're looking at Athens, Georgia, getting hit with some heavy rain and maybe even a thunderstorm that's crossing over I-20 at this time. Taking a look at the bigger picture, although the cloud cover really wasn't that impressive across many areas in the southeast, we didn't see very much breakup in the cloud cover, no sun. So we saw a lot of that patchy, dense fog wedged in towards the southeast. And of course, with the moisture overrunning that cooler air, we will continue to see the fog worsen in the low Mississippi Valley area, especially streams and rivers. If you live in near a stream or a river, count on the patchy fog getting worse overnight tonight. These are the current temperatures. Lots of 40s and 50s at this hour. 45 degrees in Atlanta. Visibility has been down below 3 miles much of the day today. Columbia, South Carolina, it's currently 45. But out ahead of our warm front, it's warm. Still looking at 70 in Orlando, 74 in Tampa, and 75 in Miami. The further to the northeast we go, well, we saw some sun earlier today, but we've been looking at more and more of the cloud cover move in across the mid-Atlantic, and that too will be spreading to the New England areas over the course of tomorrow. Right now in Boston, it's 32, 35 in New York. What can you anticipate for tomorrow in New York? We will wake up to cloudy skies and some light rain likely to be in the area, but rain. We're only likely to see the temperatures dipping into the low 30s tonight, and then they will be climbing up with an easterly flow. We're looking for 40s for the afternoon high temperatures. Right now in Philadelphia, overcast skies, 34, all the moisture to the west moving our way. High pressure will give way, and that means the overcast skies will take over too. No sunshine for New England tomorrow. Dave?
Okay, Lisa, let's head west, and well, we found some decent weather today. It's not all bad. El Paso with a sunny day, 60. Phoenix, sunny and 65. And Palm Springs, sunny and 70. The southwest corner of the United States was where the sun shone today. But in the Pacific Northwest and northern Rockies, it has been one rocky ride. Particularly behind this area of low pressure, notice all the isobar lines. That indicates a strong pressure gradient, which gives rise to strong winds. And in eastern Washington, this is what it looked like. Spokane is the place, and here you are with the snow just pelting you in the face. The Spokane area got between 4 or 5 inches of snow, and winds were gusting to 44 miles per hour. It's much nicer now, but there still is that snow out on the ground. Fortunately, the strong winds have moved out of Washington for the most part and headed eastward, where wind chill in Glasgow, 63 below zero. It's that kind of cold and wind that will spread south and east. Lisa?
Let's take a look at that forecast. One more time, we focus on the midsection of the country. Well, really, it's not you just alone. Anywhere from the Mississippi Valley onward to the east, we've got some tough times ahead. One of the reasons we're going to see the colder air push a little further to the south is because we've had a very large amplification in our long wave pattern. The trough has been pushing colder air, or allowing colder air to push further and further to the south. And we're looking at that ridge in place across the west, but still seeing an onshore flow, and that means more systems are likely to come on board. Now, as we go through the day tomorrow, keep in mind that we're looking at a couple of areas of low pressure come together. So this will be a system that winds up and will produce significant wind. And even though we're only anticipating 2 to 6 inches of snow, a lot of the snow on the ground and that falling will be blowing around. And at times, we won't be able to see. And not only will the wind blow the snow around, it will produce wind chills that will be dangerously cold. And also keep in mind, in upstate New York, around Watertown, Fort Drum, icy conditions are in the forecast for you. Looking at overnight tonight with precipitation, Nashville, we're seeing some rain showers. Memphis, we could get hit again. We're looking at some snow towards the Wasatch, already looking at some 2 feet of snow in the interior sections of the Rockies. But as we go through this weekend, you'll notice another system coming on board that will put a halt even to the skiers as we go through into Monday. Looking at our system now, the wind is really wrapping up. Boy, is that very indicated, very much specified by the tightening of these isobars here across the midsection of the country. Blowing snow, dangerously cold temperatures. Needless to say, it's going to be treacherous for travelers if it's at all possible, and most advisable not to go out during this blizzard. It's going to be quite a challenge to be out.
Good advice. We'll check on travel conditions coming up right after this.
Is your asthma really under control?
Yes, but I still get short of breath.
And you wake up at night wheezing and coughing.
I just use my fast-acting inhaler.
But you use it almost every day.
Is that what you call control? Ask your doctor if Flovent is right for you. Prescription Flovent twice a day helps control the inflammation that can cause everyday asthma symptoms. Even helps improve lung function. Flovent won't replace fast-acting inhalers for sudden attacks. People switching from an oral steroid like prednisone to Flovent, an inhaled steroid, need to be especially careful. While adjusting to the switch, your body is not as able to heal after surgery, infection, or a serious injury. See your doctor if your asthma does not improve. So, is your asthma really under control? Call 1-800-2-FLOVENT today for a $5 rebate and a free asthma workbook so you and your doctor can determine if your asthma is really under control. That's 1-800-2-FLOVENT.
Now this is asthma control.
Airport delays, plenty of them. There'll be plenty more on Saturday and Sunday. I am Dave Schwartz with TravelWise. Let's be careful out there on the roadways and the flyways, too. Look at this. Chicago's O'Hare Airport reporting average incoming delays of 3 hours. Average incoming delays. And I just read a report out of Hartsfield International Airport. Average delays, 4 hours. We've got rain in the Atlanta metropolitan area, but a big storm is beginning to wind up. This moisture is heading that way. This moisture is heading that way, back toward the Twin Cities. And this moisture is heading this way. We've got the snow on the cold side. We've got the rain and the fog and the thunderstorms on the warm side of the storm. Wow. Be very, very careful out here tonight. Dense fog advisories are in effect all across East Texas, and we are pea soup thick right now in the Dallas-Fort Worth Metroplex. But tomorrow morning, those winds will be strong here in North Central and Northeast Texas. And look at this, 50 mile per hour wind gust or more than that. Here in the Northeast, we've had high pressure in control since the last snowstorm blew through. That's out in the Canadian Maritimes now, but high pressure centered over Maine is retreating eastward. Low pressure is headed our way, and so will the inclement weather. As the day wears on, travel conditions will go downhill quickly up the Hudson River Valley, north of Ossining, up to Saratoga Springs, and then north to Burlington. In some of the valleys, that's where we'll see icing. Coast, just rain, and rain all weekend, especially here in New England. In Tennessee, flash flood warnings have just been issued for 1 to 3 inches of rain. It's that stormy weather that's headed east, and it could be severe, too.
Now, when I was a young boy, at the age of 5, my mother said I'd be the greatest man alive. But a man, I'm a full-grown man. I'm a man.
Christmas classic is born.
How did I get here?
This isn't my house.
The Family Man is touching, soulful, and hilarious.
Oh.
Not only the perfect holiday movie.
You want me.
That is the general idea.
But one of the best films of the year.
God, you're beautiful.
Nicolas Cage.
Ta-da!
The Family Man.
Have a great day.
Rated PG-13 at theaters Friday, December 22nd.
This week at Walgreens, the 1 cent sale, where you can buy one and get the second for a penny. Buy a 50 bulb light set at $2.99 and get a second for a penny. Buy a roll of Clio 30-inch gift wrap for $1.99, get another roll for a penny. A box of holiday cards is $3.99. A second box is a penny. Assorted designer fragrance is only $4.95. Buy one, get a second for a penny. And buy L'Oreal Color Riche lipstick for $6.99, get a second for a penny. Walgreens, making Christmas merrier.
Hi, I'm Alan Smith. We're celebrating the holiday season at the nation's largest privately owned home.
Join the Weather Channel's gardening expert, P. Alan Smith, as he helps you gear up for the winter holidays right here on the Weather Channel.
Last year, I went to my sister's house for the holidays. I love the holidays. It's great to be with your family. I had a wonderful time, a delicious meal. It was great to be around the kids.
Did I mention they got a new dog?
Well, this holiday, I'm going to go to 1-800-Flowers.com and look for something nice to send.
Because I can't make it this year.
I want them to know I'm thinking of them, and I'm looking for some ideas.
I'm sure I can find something nice to send them, some evergreens.
It looks like they have a lot to choose from.
I could send them a basket. I think they'll like that.
Once you look around, you see how easy it is to find the right gift.
There's gourmet chocolates. There's a bunch of different options there. It's easy.
I know they'll really love what I picked out.
I'm kind of disappointed that I can't be there this year. I love my sister. Crazy about my nephew. It reminds me of myself when I was that age.
Hi, I'm Jim McCann from 1-800-Flowers.com. Visit us online or call us at 1-800-Flowers today.
Right now, it's your local forecast on the Weather Channel.
It is now 9 minutes till the top of the hour. I'm meteorologist Lisa Mozer. You're watching Storm Watch. Let's take a look at the big picture, and then we'll take a look at some of the trouble spot areas. It's the weekend, Friday. We made it through the day, right? Well, some of us did with ease, and some of us did with some trouble. We've been looking at an Arctic air mass. It's pushing southward, and we've had blowing snow and drifting snow, and at times visibility has been zero in parts of the Sawtooth Range around Montana, where the colder air is pushing further and further southward. Eventually, you see that circulation? Let me back this up one more time. The circulation right here across the panhandle of Nebraska, that area, that piece of energy, that circulation is going to get a little boost as it comes a little closer to the Mississippi River, especially the mid-Mississippi River Valley, because we have a weak low that's going to push more of the moisture that's currently around the Tennessee Valley area further to the north. Areas of low pressure will merge together, and we're going to see some significant windup in our system. It's going to be a blizzard maker. That's what we've been talking about for Saturday. Now, right now, things are not too bad, although it was a pretty rough day, especially if you were in Missouri. Along Interstate 44, a number of accidents involved multiple vehicles were plagued in the area because of icing. Somewhere between a tenth and a quarter of an inch of ice collected on many of the roadways, trees, and property around the Missouri area. So travel from Joplin, Missouri up to St. Louis along Interstate 44 was almost impossible at times. We're still seeing a little bit of a mix of precipitation up around Chicago. We've had some light freezing drizzle mixed in with some wintry precipitation, a mix, some rain and some snow and a little freezing rain occasionally too. We're getting a break now out towards the Indianapolis area. You go further to the south and this is rain, but watch out Cincinnati, Dayton, Columbus, Ohio. You could be looking at a wintry mix, especially as we go into the next several hours, overnight tonight, that is. Looking at rain showers across the Memphis area, a few thunderstorms have been plaguing the mid and central areas of Tennessee around Nashville and over to Knoxville. We've had some thunderstorms. We're looking at a mix of precipitation to linger overnight tonight across parts of Illinois, Indiana, and moving into Michigan. But the cold air is pushing southward, and that means more cold winter conditions for the plains. We'll be looking at some dangerously cold temperatures tomorrow, but as early as tonight, we'll be looking at blowing snow, poor visibility, and things only getting worse. Looking at the surface map, this is what we currently have. Remember I said we have a weak low. This is aiding all that moisture pushing further northward over the Tennessee Valley area. The circulation that's most identifiable along the satellite is over the panhandle right now. By tomorrow this time, we'll be looking at one low probably over the Indianapolis area, and on the backside of it, some of the worst conditions possible with winter weather, blowing snow, drifting snow, and very cold temperatures with wind chills that will produce dangerously cold conditions for anyone trying to brave the outdoors tomorrow night. We'll be looking at some thunderstorms across the low Mississippi Valley area, plaguing parts of Georgia eventually in the evening hours. To the Pacific Northwest, another system coming on board, and this one too promises to bring snow to the Cascades and the Northern Rockies.
I'm Dr. Norman Gary, and I'm a bee expert. All right, bee.
Dr. Norman Gary will do some pretty outrageous things.
I've been stung probably around 75,000 times.
But would Norm Gary ever get car insurance that didn't come with a State Farm agent?
Car insurance with no State Farm agent? Now that makes me nervous.
For car insurance, be like this State Farm customer.
Enjoy.
And get an agent you can rely on.
Here, have some more.
Plus competitive rates.
Can we still drive our cars and have cleaner air? We think so. Today, BP is improving air quality in 50 major cities around the world and across the U.S. by introducing cleaner burning gasoline and diesel fuels. It's not an end to the problem, but the solution has to start somewhere. BP.
Know someone who could use a nice home improvement gift? The Home Depot has this great Dremel Variable Speed Multi-Pro Super Kit. It's just $79.97. Or this rigid 6-gallon wet-dry vac, just $39.97. And you'll never go wrong giving these handy gift cards. It's all at the Home Depot, where low prices are just the beginning.
You're hot.
Excuse me?
How about a V8 splash to cool you down?
No, thanks.
I know what you're thinking. Oh, V8, it must be rich and tomatoey. But in fact, V8 splash is refreshing and fruity.
Mm. It is fruity.
See what happens when you make judgments based on outward appearance? Now, how about your phone number?
No.
I thought we learned a lesson here.
Fruity V8 splash, a very different V8, now in new diet.
Get a jump on your day with the travel, business, and weather information you need. Join Rick Griffin and Cheryl Lemke on First Outlook, weekdays 5 to 7 a.m. Eastern on the Weather Channel.
The Weather Channel is brought to you by this cable or satellite provider. You can also get reliable forecasts from the Weather Channel through this radio station.
Next week on Atmospheres, tracking twisters on the ground. Storm chasers capture killer tornadoes on tape. Plus, watch hurricane hunters in the air as they fly into the eye of a hurricane. And log on to weather.com/atmospheres to interact while you watch. Don't miss Atmospheres, a new hour-long magazine show hosted by meteorologists Jim Cantore and Mitch Michaels, Wednesdays at 8 on the Weather Channel. You've never seen weather like this before.
Right now, it's your local forecast on the Weather Channel.
You are looking at world-famous Michigan Avenue along Chicago's waterfront. This is one of the places where ice is complicating travel tonight. And this is the Mall of America, just outside Minneapolis. It's windy tonight, but it will get even worse tomorrow. Good evening and welcome to Weather Center, sponsored by the U.S. Postal Service. I'm Carl Parker.
And I'm Dave Schwartz. Further south, the threat for Saturday is for, get this, tornadoes. We'll tell you more about that in just a few minutes, but first, to the Midwest and Northern Plains. That's where the storm will be felt. It's already beginning to be felt here in Rapid City. That cold front just blasted through, and is it getting windy and cold? Look at all the areas of low pressure, and they're right here in the middle of the United States. One low across the polar front, and then a couple of other low pressure areas here, a lee side low. This is where the storm is getting to crank. Can you see it? Can you see the beginnings of the turn of the moisture coming this way, of the cold air coming that way? the last in a series of upper-level disturbances that's going to carve this big storm out is coming out through northern Colorado right now. That will head eastward, and then we are going to have ourselves quite a weekend. Red in the southeast, that's strong thunderstorms. Orange and pink in the northeast, that's ice and sleet. Rain in Pennsylvania, south through the Appalachians, that's rain. And white indicated where the heavy snow will fall and a lot of wind too. And our Mike Seidel is standing by there in Bloomington, Minnesota, just outside Minneapolis, where conditions are going to get much worse later tonight and tomorrow. Mike?
They are, Dave. In fact, the wind by this time tomorrow will be howling out of the northwest, driving the wind chill down to 50, maybe 55 below zero. And I'll be out in it. We'll see how it feels. It was pretty cold last weekend, but this is going to be even colder. It'll be a quick shot of wind. By Sunday morning, the wind will diminish. But what's going to happen, we're going to get another inch or two of snow overnight and tomorrow, and then we'll get the wind, and that will blow around what snow falls and what snow is on the ground. And this is very dry, powdery snow. You can't make a snowball, and watch what happens. That's with very little wind. It just blows around. So the visibilities are going to be restricted if you're going to be doing any kind of driving tomorrow evening. Keep that in mind, especially out in the rural areas. Another thing that's going to be happening tomorrow, the wind comes up, the temperatures fall. Check the forecast. It's 19 right now. We'll go down to about 18. Temperatures basically steady overnight. And then by afternoon, falling back to 4 and 0 at 5. And you add in that northwest wind at 35 miles an hour. And you don't have to do the math. I'll do it for you. Wind chills of 50 and even colder below zero here in the Twin Cities. Again, not a lot of snowfall. Now, by Sunday morning, the winds will die off, temperatures between about 5 and 10 below. The highs Sunday and Monday and Tuesday only in the single numbers. Typically, this time of the year, it should be about 22 or 23 degrees. So another very cold period coming into the upper Midwest. And by the way, the same front is moving east. So those of you in Chicago and then New York and Boston, you'll feel the effects of this front by Sunday with very strong winds along the East Coast and some lake effect snow. Dave? We'll be hunkered down and bundled up for this one tomorrow night.
Enjoy your nice mild night in Bloomington tonight, Mike. We'll see you tomorrow.
We are.
Well, let's take a look at the current situation here in the Midwest. Mother Nature has been nickel and diming us tonight. We've got some rain in Tennessee moving up towards Cincinnati. That'll be all rain. But notice the orange on this. That indicates where it's rain that's freezing on the way down, either becoming sleet or freezing on surfaces, freezing rain. We saw that earlier today in St. Louis. That moved out of the way, but on I-44 in southwest Missouri, there were numerous multi-car pileups. And we've had some freezing rain in Chicago. That's also gone. A little sleet and freezing rain here in Detroit, and that is just about gone too. A little light snow from about Madison to Milwaukee and points north up toward Green Bay. Very light snow tonight, but this is just the beginning. Here in Chicago, we're glad to see that go. A little bit of rain out in the western suburbs around Elgin. Otherwise, we're in the upper 20s, and that's where we'll stay for the most part tonight with southeasterly winds. Temperatures are actually here in the Midwest warmer than they were 24 hours ago, and by a bunch. But it's still cold out here. That gives you an idea of how cold it was here last night. Meanwhile, in Williston, it's 2, Bismarck 6, Pier 14. It's that cold air that's headed eastward, and we've got cold air in the northeast. Moisture's on the way also. We're looking for frozen precipitation, interior sections of New York, PA, and New England. Carl?
And we want to take you into the southeast, where we're concerned about the possibility of severe weather over the next couple of days. There's a lot going on, and as we show you the water vapor loop here, we've got this first upper disturbance in the Midwest. That's the one that's producing the active weather now in terms of freezing rain and sleet and snow in the Midwest, and I'll show you that water vapor one more time, but there's a much more significant system a little farther along towards the west here, now in the central plains. This is the one that's really going to be digging in here. It will grab up moisture from the Gulf of Mexico, take it northward, and we'll see a lot of lift in the atmosphere. The result, we think, is going to be severe weather through a lot of the southeast, starting overnight tonight, probably very early tomorrow. It could really light up here in, say, Louisiana around the Sabine River, extending into Mississippi, and that area will travel eastward through the day tomorrow. Could really be very, very active in these areas. Right now, we do have some fairly heavy rain across Tennessee, a couple of flood warnings associated with that heavy rain. We'll take you on a little radar tour. It's beginning to light up already in Arkansas. We're starting to feel the influence of that upper system, the upper forcing off to the west here. As that lift increases, we'll see these storms really begin to bubble up again overnight, and it will really kick in tomorrow. So scattered showers and storms here, the eastern part of Arkansas towards Little Rock. Most of these moving along towards the northeast, but nothing severe as of yet. And we're also seeing heavier rain across Tennessee and a little farther eastward here, south and east of Atlanta. So there's your thunderstorm forecast. Severe weather anticipated in red here. How about the west? Here's Dave.
Well, the big story here in the west, Carl, has been wind. It has been very, very strong in the wake of the storm. Low pressure, and to the west, we've had a very tight pressure gradient. Temperatures were nice and mild in the southwest. They'll remain that way. But the storm track is right in here and heading off toward the east coast. There's our cold air. The coldest air in the country right now is here in Montana. And you factor in the wind, and you're in trouble. We were in trouble here in Seattle. Last night, some trees came down. The winds were so strong, a southeast suburb of Seattle, a tree came down and turned a single home into a duplex just like that. Fortunately, nobody was injured. It's that kind of strong wind that's toppling trees tonight in the northern Rockies and out into the plains, bringing wind chills down below 60 below zero. Now here's your forecast with Carl.
And it's going to be a wild day tomorrow, no question about that. We expect to see the snow here flying in the upper Midwest, in the northern plains, a lot of snow, a lot of wind, blowing snow. Travel is going to be absolutely treacherous here in the northern part of the country. It's also going to be extremely cold. We're talking about wind chills on the order of 60 to 80 degrees below zero. And again, farther south and east, where we have the moisture coming up here, severe weather possibility. We could see tornadic storms, Mississippi, Alabama, North Florida, and Georgia. Be very careful tomorrow if you live in these areas. Stay tuned, and we will let you know what's going on. There's a look at your high temps tomorrow in the single numbers and teens here. And again, you factor in those winds, and we are talking about forecast wind chills on the order of 60 to 80 degrees below zero. You do not want to mess around with weather like that. That is dangerous weather. You could lose your life in that kind of weather.
A good day to stay inside.
Absolutely.
Watch football on TV and the Weather Channel, of course.
Stay tuned. We'll have more coming up.
This program was sponsored by Priority Mail from the U.S. Postal Service.
You probably know, as it's often been stated, giving holiday gifts can be quite complicated. The post office is where you should go, no doubt. You can pack up your stuff and ship it on out. Get last-minute gifts if you've got a late start. Even rush them away to arrive Christmas Day, in case you've had a sudden change of heart.
Fly like an eagle.
Your call will be answered by the next available operator. Please stand by.
Your service reps are overwhelmed with customer calls, faxes, and emails. Integrate the internet into your call center and go from providing customer support to creating customer delight. Discover all that's possible on the internet. Cisco Systems, empowering the internet generation.
Happy birthday, Dad.
Campbell's tomato soup, huh?
You always knew Campbell's was good. You just didn't know how good tomatoes could be. Recent studies have shown that diets rich in tomato products are associated with a reduced risk of certain types of cancer. And all eight Campbell's tomato soups are full of tomato goodness.
There's enough Campbell's here to last me 100 years.
That's the whole idea. Campbell's. Mm-mm good. Want a quick snack? Try Campbell's ready-to-serve tomato soup in the resealable container.
Right now, it's your local forecast on the Weather Channel.
Well, I'll tell you, it's going to be quite a day tomorrow. We're talking about a lot of wind, a lot of snow, extremely cold weather here in the middle of the country. A very powerful system is going to be dropping down into the middle Mississippi Valley, and then farther southward, severe weather a possibility. Lots going on here. We have a lot of lift in the atmosphere, a big change in temperature, big change in pressure, and as a result, a tremendous amount of wind on the back side of the system. Notice that the isobars are very tightly packed through here. We're talking about winds gusting to potentially 40, 50, maybe 60 miles an hour, and wind chills way, way below zero, and I'll show you that in just a moment. 60 to 80 degrees below zero in the northern plains, and you can't survive that for very long. So keep that in mind. If you're thinking about traveling, for example, from Minneapolis to Lincoln tomorrow, you may want to cancel that plan, because it really could be dangerous. If you got stuck for some reason, you'd have a very, very difficult time at that point, and you could get stuck. Now, we're not talking about a whole lot of snow necessarily, but the snow is going to be blowing around, and that will reduce the visibilities to perhaps zero in some cases, because the wind will be so strong. Again, farther south and east here, moisture coming up from the Gulf of Mexico, a lot of lift in the atmosphere. We'll see showers and thunder showers. Very strong thunderstorms are a possibility. And because we will see some shear, some turning of wind with height in the atmosphere, we could see tornadic storms in the southeast tomorrow. It could be pretty rough, so do keep that in mind. Farther north and eastward, rain here in the northeast, maybe a bit of a mix across the lakes in the northeast. And in the west, it's going to be rain and snow, and a little bit of a mix in some spots. So here's how it looks once again. Blizzard conditions here. Minnesota, just outside of Minneapolis, perhaps a little farther westward, and right on down towards western Iowa. It's really going to be very difficult here tomorrow. If you don't have to go anywhere, just don't do it. Windy weather all the way down into Little Rock, Arkansas. A lot of rain here in the mid-Atlantic region, and again, those very strong storms in the southeast. That could really start early tomorrow and farther westward, perhaps right here around Louisiana, Mississippi. Very strong storms in the morning, and that will begin to shift towards the east as we go through the day. And then in the northwest, we're talking about snow here in the Bitterroots, Northern Rockies, and some wet weather in the Pacific Northwest. On Sunday, our storm moves along towards the east. Front blasts through. We'll see that windy weather all the way down into the southeast. Huge changes in some areas. Jacksonville, Florida, for example, where it has been very warm and very humid for a few days now, it's going to be much, much colder and very windy as that Arctic air blasts on in. We'll see snow showers lingering here in the lakes, rainy weather in the northeast, snow showers also in the northern plains and the high plains, another piece of energy dropping in. We'll watch another front come through the middle of the country on Monday. So a few showers in the lower Mississippi Valley, some snow perhaps in the high plains, central plains. And then as we go on into Tuesday, snow showers in the Ohio Valley, our system continuing to work eastward. And there are some hints that we could see a little coastal storm develop on Wednesday that would throw moisture back into the cold air, and the result could be snow in interior parts of the northeast. Then things really begin to quiet down by Thursday and into Friday. Some active weather in West Texas and New Mexico. High temperatures tomorrow in the teens and single numbers in the northern plains. You factor in that wind, we're talking about wind chills of 60 to 80 below. North and South Dakota and Nebraska, you do not want to mess with that kind of a wind chill. That's very, very cold, and you couldn't survive for very long in that. So be careful tomorrow if you're going to be traveling across this region. On Sunday, we see some moderation, but it continues to be very cold in the northern part of the country right into Monday.
We get really dry skin.
Dry, itchy skin.
For dry, itchy skin, these non-medicated moisturizers all fall short of Gold Bond Medicated Body Lotion. Triple Action Gold Bond moisturizes, protects, and stops itch. Gold Bond Medicated Body Lotion. More than a moisturizer, it's medicated.
In football, power and speed make a winning combination. Same for pain relief. So most pro athletes demand the power and speed of Flexol. Flexol rushes relief straight to the pain to keep you going strong. Flexol, powerful full-speed relief for tough pain.
Everyone knows what it feels like to be congested. That's why there are different Afrinodrip nasal sprays. Ordinary sprays drip. Afrinodrip targets nasal congestion and stays there for fast, powerful relief. New Afrinodrip nasal sprays.
Need extra cash for the holidays? Don't charge it on your credit cards. Get a second mortgage with no closing costs from ditech.com. With a second mortgage, you can consolidate all your existing high-interest debts, get the cash you need for the holidays, and end up with one lower monthly payment. A second mortgage with no closing costs is smart money from DITECH.com. Log on now for fast online approval or call us at 1-800-71-FIX.
When you have shrimp and crab claws coming together, you have yourself a spectacular holiday party. Pick up a Red Lobster party platter and go overboard.
You love seafood, we love seafood. Let's meet at Red Lobster tonight and go overboard.
Next week on Atmospheres, storm chasers capture killer tornadoes on tape. And watch hurricane hunters as they fly into the eye of a hurricane. Don't miss Atmospheres with meteorologists Jim Cantore and Mitch Michaels, Wednesdays at 8 on the Weather Channel.
The tarot cards can inspire you to unleash your emotions and live a healthier life.
I filed for divorce, but I stopped it.
Betty.
Yes?
Oh, baby, look. There has been an issue. Now, did you get confirmation from him? Did he finally admit to the infidelity?
He's got a woman living with him, yes.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. I still love him. And we've been together 9 years.
Betty.
Yeah.
Why would you chase after a man that is living in a house with another woman? At the end of all of this, sweetness, there is a death card, which means that there is an end to all of this, honey.
Is there?
Yeah, baby.
You don't see her leaving?
No, man. The Two of Cups is there for them. So I'm just saying to you, while you love him, don't continue to invite the heartache, sweetie. It is time to move on, all right, Betty?
Yeah.
Start your spiritual journey with a free tarot card reading.
Call 1-800-342-9931.
Right now, it's your local forecast on the Weather Channel.
Well, Old Man Winter is very impatient. The official start of winter is about a week away, but already we've had a couple of big storms in the middle of the country, and a very powerful storm is going to be dropping down into the middle of the country tomorrow. Let's take a look at the water vapor loop now, and we have a couple of systems that we want to point out. One is a very weak system now making its way through the Midwest. It's a little difficult to see at this point, but there is a little bit of a disturbance right here. And with that, we've seen some freezing rain and some snow in parts of the Midwest. But the far more potent system is now in the Central Plains. That is going to be working eastward, and we're going to see severe weather in the southeast tomorrow and a terrific amount of wind and snow in the northern plains. So we've got a big mess on the surface map, a series of low pressures at the surface here. Bottom line is, tomorrow in the southeast, severe weather in the middle of the country, Arctic air diving on down, and a lot of rain in the eastern part of the country. Let's focus in on this area right here. And again, we've seen some mixed precipitation in the Midwest. Chicago has been reporting freezing rain. Temperatures are in the 20s. And the rain is not terribly heavy. It has been light, but it certainly could cause some problems. You do want to watch out for that later on tonight. We're talking about a mix changing over to rain here in the southern lakes and then snow a little farther along towards the north. southeast. We've got some showers and some thunder showers. Thunder showers beginning to develop here in Arkansas as that upper level lift swings on in. We'll see more of this kind of thing overnight and certainly through the day tomorrow. And we do have some heavier rains across Tennessee. Nashville, it's been a pretty wet night, and more of the same as we extend towards Chattanooga and parts of western North Carolina. The thunderstorms will really pick up, we think, in the morning hours tomorrow. We're talking about severe weather potentially for Louisiana and Mississippi. It could be pretty rough, and that's going to continue through the day tomorrow. And again, farther north and west, we have Arctic air diving on down. It is extremely cold here. We're not expecting a whole lot in the way of snow, but a lot of wind. So that snow is going to be blowing around. That's going to make it very difficult to travel. And look at the temperatures here, 11 below in Cutbank, 8 below in Glasgow. Factoring in the winds, feels like 63 below in Glasgow, Montana right now. That's extraordinarily cold and dangerous cold, and we're going to see more of that tomorrow in the northern plains. Take this very, very seriously. It's going to be very, very life-threatening here in the northern part of the country tomorrow. A large area with wind chills of 60 to 80 degrees below zero. So the snow will be flying here in the western lakes, northern plains, Minneapolis. You're going to get hit, and again, we're not talking about a huge snowmaker here, but it's going to be very windy and extremely cold. A lot of rain farther eastward here. Severe weather develops in the mid-south in the morning hours, moves a little farther eastward into the southeast as we go through the middle of the day. There could be tornadic storms. Notice this area of red right here. That's where we're expecting the severe weather tomorrow. Blizzard conditions in the northern plains, a lot of wind, and we'll also see wet and snowy weather in the Pacific Northwest. We'll have more on all of this coming up in just a few minutes on Weather Center. Stay tuned.
When you're away from your television, check out the skier's forecast on the World Wide Web at weather.com. We'll provide you with easy access to the latest ski conditions and even webcam views of selected resorts around the country. That's skier's forecast from the Weather Channel at weather.com or America Online keyword weather.
This program was brought to you by Acura, introducing the all-new Acura CL Sports Coupe.
Acura MDX, taking the SUV to a place it's never been before.
At Penske Auto Centers, buy four all-season radials on sale as low as $79. Just $79 for four top-quality 13-inch all-season radials during Penske's tire sale. 14 and 15-inch all-season radials also on sale as low as $129 and $149 for four. Buy three Goodyear Spectra or Penske tires. Get the fourth free every day. Get a 90-day same-as-cash opportunity with the Penske Visa card. Penske Auto Centers, conveniently located at most Kmarts.
Penske Auto Center, the quality car care system.
Inside Prudential.com, there's so much you can do and learn. Hear what our stock market experts are saying. Learn all about IRAs and 401ks. Get an instant life insurance quote, or even find a new home. Prudential.com has all kinds of interactive tools to help you save, plan, and invest. It's so easy to use. And there's always something new happening, from insurance to real estate to investments. It's all right here at Prudential.com.
The accuracy of the tarot cards is amazing. Just watch. You pass up a good one. You know what? You pass him up about 6 months or so ago because he was taking a bus. You know the one I am talking about, don't you?
Yes.
Uh-huh. He was a good one. You mess up. Have you been hearing rumors about someone selling the company?
Oh, my God. I can't believe it. I cannot believe you.
And you will be back in court in the next 21 days, won't you?
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
On your calf, on the lower part of your leg, there is a mark or something there. What is that?
I don't know where it's come from, but there is one there.
And this younger man now is going to try and use you. So be careful and mind yourself. Because you know you are already giving him things. What did you go and buy him 2-3 weeks ago?
I bought him a watch.
Uh-huh. Call me now for your free reading and get all the answers you need right now.
1-800-400-2092.
Next week on Atmospheres, storm chasers capture killer tornadoes on tape. And watch hurricane hunters as they fly into the eye of a hurricane. Don't miss Atmospheres with meteorologists Jim Cantore and Mitch Michaels, Wednesdays at 8 on the Weather Channel.
When I was a little girl, a teacher gave me an important gift. She opened my eyes to the love of learning. To inspire learning today, many teachers turn to cable in the classroom. For 10 years, cable has helped teachers teach by donating technology to schools. With commercial-free educational programs and internet support, cable in the classroom helps teachers help kids. In my eyes, that's a powerful gift.
Cable in the classroom is a public service of the Weather Channel and your local cable company.
It's easy to access weather.com on America Online. Just enter keyword weather or point and click. It's so simple, you can quickly check the weather online and still have plenty of time left over to get outside and enjoy it. Weather.com on America Online. Keyword weather.
Traveling? Weather.com offers everything you need to know to plan your next trip. Well, almost everything.
Your weather today, a new way to start your day from the experts at the Weather Channel. Marshall Cease and Heather Tesh examine the conditions and bring you the latest forecast to help you plan your day. Dennis Smith shows you any travel trouble spots. And Dr. John Scala keeps you ahead of the storm with severe weather updates. More of the information you want, including your local forecast on the 8th of each hour. Your weather today, weekday mornings from 7 till 9 Eastern on the Weather Channel.
Right now, it's your local forecast on the Weather Channel.
Well, the weekend is setting up to be a rough one with blizzard conditions in the Midwest and the threat of tornadoes in the Southeast. Good evening and welcome to Weather Center. I'm Carl Parker.
And I'm Dave Schwartz. More on the forecast in just a minute, but first a look at what's going on out there right now. And it gives you the sense that something is up in the middle of the country. Notice the fair weather high pressure over Maine and out over the Atlantic Ocean. Another one in Canada, and a third one off the screen, off the California coast. Here in the United States, it's low pressure, stormy weather. Typically, high pressure likes to hang out over land this time of year, and low pressure out over the water, because it's warmer there than it is here. Not so this time. A very dynamic situation is setting up for us right in the nation's heartland. It's all rain here. It's freezing rain, sleet, and snow there. All snow here. And this is just a little cakewalk, a little walk in the park tonight compared to what happens Saturday and Sunday from the Rocky Mountains all the way to the Delaware River. Rain, severe thunderstorms, blizzard conditions here, and an ice storm from Traverse City to Millinocket, Maine. All right, let's get into the particulars. Notice the merry-go-round. These echoes heading that way. These echoes heading this way. and a big storm is going to set up right in here and head toward the East Coast Sunday and Monday. Right now, it is freezing drizzle on the west side of Chicago. On top of all that snow we've got, temperatures are running in the upper 20s. More freezing drizzle for Downers Grove and Wheaton, Roselle, and Elgin. Here in Chicago, though, just cloudy skies. It looks like it's going to remain that way. But temperatures are below freezing, and they'll stay that way, so they'll be icing once again. We've got snow all over the place. Now we get ice on bridges and overpasses. Be very careful. Temperatures, however, on the east side of the storm are warming up. It's actually 26 degrees warmer in Green Bay right now than it was yesterday, and still it's cold enough for snow, and that's precisely what's headed your way right up the lakefront. Not a lot of snow, but wait until tomorrow. Meanwhile, here in the east, it's cold in interior sections of New York State and Maine, below freezing all the way down toward Hot Springs, Virginia. This is where we can see a little freezing rain. Here in Pittsburgh, we're 33 degrees, light rain beginning to spread into western Pennsylvania, a little icing, bridges and overpasses only, but the temperatures here will be warming up too. That'll keep us above the freezing mark as the rain moves in. Here in the northeast, we're beginning to cloud over, and that's it for sun all the way through the weekend. Say goodbye to high pressure. We head further south, and get this, the threat for severe weather even tonight. Here's Carl with that story.
And as you mentioned, Dave, we've got a real mess of low pressure in the middle of the country, a series of surface lows, but the main upper low is right here. You can really see it beginning to dig in, and ahead of it, we have a lot of uplift in the atmosphere. Rising motion, that's one of the main things that we look for when forecasting severe weather, upper forcing, and that's occurring right here, and as that moves farther eastward and taps into deeper moisture, we're going to see very strong thunderstorms tomorrow. Now notice, if you will, that we've got a boundary camped out right along the Gulf Coast right now. That's where the very warm and very humid air is. If it were to stay there, then we wouldn't have to worry as much about severe weather. But what's going to happen is this storm is so strong, it's going to create its own environment. As it drops down to the southeast, it's going to grab that very warm and very humid air and take it up and into the storm. So we've got the juice, we've got the warm air, very buoyant air, we've got upper forcing. Everything is coming together tomorrow, and I'll tell you, we could really be in for some nasty weather towards the afternoon. We've had a lot of rain tonight in Tennessee. Nashville, a very wet night indeed. There have been some thunderstorms too. And then farther along towards the west here, thunderstorms beginning to break out in Arkansas. And this is the area that we're going to be watching overnight tonight. We've got deeper moisture along to the south, and we're concerned about the potential for severe weather here in Louisiana and Mississippi overnight and through the mid-morning tomorrow, and that entire area is going to be shifting eastward as we go through the day tomorrow, and that is something that we're going to have to watch very, very carefully. Our severe weather expert, Dr. Greg Forbes, has been watching the situation very carefully, and here is his analysis.
A very strong winter system is going to bring warm air north from the Gulf of Mexico. That means that beginning tonight, there could be the possibility of hail and damaging winds, and then tornadoes tomorrow. That warm air will flow northward off the Gulf of Mexico ahead of this strong low pressure system. Everywhere tomorrow morning except the Appalachian Mountain areas will have warm air in place at the surface. That'll mean the possibility of hail and high winds overnight tonight from Louisiana across Mississippi and Alabama. During the day tomorrow, that low pressure system and cold front push east, and the severe weather moves with it, developing the possibility of tornadoes, especially across the center part of this red area, Birmingham, Alabama, Montgomery, Alabama, central Georgia into the Carolinas. Even some hail as far north as Kentucky, and high winds as well, all the way to the coast of the Carolinas. Now let's go back to the studio.
And that wraps up the east. Now how about the west? Here's Dave.
Well, Carl, it was a pretty quiet day in the west. Windy, but quiet, at least in the southwest. But here in the northwest of Northern Rockies, well, in the wake of this big storm, just count the isobars. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, we go on and on, but there's strong high pressure over western Canada and a deepening or strengthening area of low pressure in Nebraska. Wind right now at Imperial, Nebraska, gusting to 54 miles per hour, and upper level winds four times that, up at jet stream level, and it's that kind of upper level dynamics that's going to give rise to this big storm. It's already knocked over some trees and power lines all across Washington and Montana into Idaho, Colorado, and Wyoming. And one house in suburban Seattle began as one house, but when the tree fell on it, it became two houses immediately. Fortunately, no one was underneath that tree. There are no reports of any injuries. But with winds like this, you really have to be careful if you're driving. High country, low country, passes, plains, it doesn't matter. This storm is so strong. Look at Rapid City, 51 mile per hour wind gust. The wind chill way down there. And that's the storm that's heading into the plains, heading into the Midwest, the South, and Northeast. Watch how this wraps up tomorrow. Here's Carl.
Wild weather tomorrow. This is a multifaceted storm. We'll watch the cold air pour down into the middle of the country. There's not going to be a whole lot of snow, but it's not going to take very much to create very treacherous driving conditions because we're going to see a lot of blowing snow. Winds gusting here to 40, 50, maybe 60 miles an hour in some cases, so it's going to be very difficult to travel. And if you were to get stranded, it would be awful because we're talking about wind chills here way below zero across this entire area. Again, farther south and east, as this boundary moves along, we'll see scattered showers and strong storms ahead of that, and perhaps some tornadic storms. It could be pretty rough at times in the deep south tomorrow, so stay tuned and we'll let you know what's going on. There's your high temperatures for tomorrow, single numbers and teens here. Factor in those winds, and we are talking about wind chills of 60 to 80 degrees below zero. That's extremely dangerous weather. You cannot survive in weather like that for very long, so be very careful if you're going to be in that region tomorrow.
One thing we haven't talked about is the dense fog tonight hampering travel in the plains.
And TravelWise is coming up in just a few minutes. Stay tuned.
Craving more taste, more variety? All you need is 99 cents. Check out the new 99 cent BK Cravers menu with 8 items including our Bullseye Barbecue Deluxe, Chicken Tender Sandwich, and Tasty Jalapeno Poppers. Just 99 cents every day.
The tarot cards can inspire you to unleash your emotions and live a healthier life.
I filed for divorce, but I stopped it.
Betty?
Yes?
Oh, baby, look. There has been an issue. Now, did you get confirmation from him? Did he finally admit to the infidelity?
He's got a woman living with him, yes.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. I still love him. And we've been together 9 years.
Betty.
Yeah?
Why would you chase after a man that is living in a house with another woman? At the end of all of this, sweetness, there is a death card, which means that there is an end to all of this, honey.
Is there?
Yeah, baby.
You don't see her leaving?
No, man. The Two of Cups is there for them. So I'm just saying to you, while you love him, don't continue to invite the heartache, sweetie. It is time to move on, all right, Betty?
Yeah.
Start your spiritual journey with a free tarot card reading.
Call 1-800-342-9931.
Right now, it's your local forecast on the Weather Channel.
Well, a big old storm is taking shape in the middle of the country, and I'll tell you, this is the real deal Holyfield. We're talking about a lot of active weather through tonight and tomorrow. It's going to be absolutely brutal in terms of cold and wind and snow. in the northern plains tomorrow, and we could see severe weather in the southeast. You can already begin to see the spin here of the upper level low kind of taking shape here. So things are coming together, and it's going to be a wild day tomorrow. More immediately, we'll get some rain here in the southeast, a mix in parts of the lakes and the middle Mississippi Valley, and blowing snow in the northern plains. So there again, a closer look, a mixture here as we get towards Chicago. Thunderstorms are a possibility overnight tonight. Severe weather here in Mississippi, down through Louisiana. There's not much going on there now, although we are seeing some storms in Arkansas. But this could really begin to blossom as we go through the overnight hours, especially towards the early morning hours, say around 6, 7 a.m. And through the day tomorrow, this entire area is going to be shifting eastward, and we could see tornadic storms tomorrow. So if you live in the southeast, Mississippi, Alabama, Georgia, North Florida, you need to stay tuned, and we will let you know what's going on tomorrow. Foggy travel here through Texas, parts of the south, and also in Southern California, the LA Basin. A lot of windy travel, winds 50 miles an hour or better here. We'll take you region by region. We'll watch rain increase through the northeast. We could see a mix in New England, so watch out for that tomorrow. Maybe some freezing rain, very wet day in D.C. and Pittsburgh and Philly. The southeast, again, it could be rough. Severe weather a possibility here, especially towards Alabama and Georgia and North Florida, and more early on, more immediately, towards Louisiana and towards Mississippi. But later in the day, we push that area a little farther along towards the east here, and we could see very, very strong storms in these areas. In the Midwest, wow, 18 degrees for your high in Minneapolis. It's going to feel much, much colder than that number right there. We're talking about wind chills in this area right here on the order of 60 to 80 degrees below zero. That is dangerous cold, and you don't want to get out in that. So just don't do it. And back towards the west, snow and rain here once again. Wet weather Pacific Northwest, 44 in Seattle, a little bit of a mix. Great day in LA, partly cloudy and about 72.
13 years ago.
Don't go, Jack.
Jack Campbell made a choice.
So you left her?
I took the road less traveled.
And look where it took you.
But this Christmas.
What do you need, Jack?
I got everything I need.
Fate is taking him down the other road.
Kate? This isn't my house.
Academy Award winner Nicolas Cage.
God, you're beautiful.
The Family Man. Rated PG-13. At theaters December 22nd.
A chunky Super Bowl moment. Terrell Davis's mom filled him up right with new Campbell's Chunky Grilled Sirloin and Vegetables. Fired up by this chunky grilled classic, Terrell made like grilled steak and sizzle.
Apparently, some people don't know Dremel also makes cordless rotary tools. Dremel cordless rotary tools. For every problem, there's a Dremel solution.
Time now for a look at your weekend, and I'll tell you, we have just about every type of weather on the map for tomorrow. We're talking about rain in the northeast, a mixture here, some freezing rain mixed with sleet or snow in New England, very strong storms in the southeast, perhaps tornadic storms in some places, blizzard conditions in the upper Midwest, extremely windy weather, blowing snow around Minneapolis and farther southward, and then in the west, snow here in the Bitterroots, a little bit of a mix in parts of eastern Washington and Oregon, and wet weather in Seattle, and then beautiful weather in the southwest. It's going to be gorgeous in LA and San Francisco tomorrow. On Sunday, we'll watch that front press on through, lingering snow showers here, very windy weather, and snow showers also into parts of the high plains and northern plains as that system moves on in. High temperatures for your Saturday in the teens here, single numbers. You can throw that out because it's not going to feel like this at all. We're talking about temperatures in the 60 to 80 degree below zero range as far as wind chills are concerned in this area during the day tomorrow.
We get really dry skin.
Dry, itchy skin.
For dry, itchy skin, these non-medicated moisturizers all fall short of Gold Bond Medicated Body Lotion. Triple Action Gold Bond moisturizes, protects, and stops itch. Gold Bond Medicated Body Lotion. More than a moisturizer, it's medicated.
In football, power and speed make a winning combination. Same for pain relief. So most pro athletes demand the power and speed of Flexol. Flexol rushes relief straight to the pain to keep you going strong. Flexol, powerful full-speed relief for tough pain.
free L.L. Bean catalog. Call 800-2-LL-BEAN.
Some joy this holiday season. Shop online, ship it on its way, and be sure it gets there in 2 to 3 days with priority mail delivery from the United States Postal Service.
Now weather.com has even more ways to help you anticipate the weather. Email. Get 7-day forecasts and information on how the weather will affect your favorite activities emailed to you every day. Weather.com, wherever you are. Sign up at email.weather.com today.
Sunshine on my shoulder.
In the 70s, the music was special.
I've seen fire and I've seen rain.
Singers touched our hearts.
I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end.
Songs touched our lives.
Now I haven't got time for the pain.
Presenting the Singers and Songwriters Collection. Get Singers and Songwriters 74-75 for just $12.99.
And the cat's in the cradle and the silver spoon. A little more.
Then audition other singer-songwriter collections. Satisfaction guaranteed.
I learned the truth at 17.
Call 1-800-731-5151 to order for $12.99 for 2 CDs or 2 cassettes plus $3.99 shipping, or send check or money order to the address on your screen.
Right now, it's your local forecast on the Weather Channel.
This storm watch is sponsored by Allstate Insurance, and we have a monster of a storm to tell you about. It's going to produce a lot of wind and extremely cold wind chills in the upper Midwest and severe weather in parts of the Southeast. Let's take a look at the water vapor loop now. We actually watched one little disturbance work its way into the Midwest, and that's continuing to produce some snow and some freezing precipitation here in the Midwest around Chicago and a little farther north and points farther east. But the big storm is this upper level low right here. You can see this thing really digging in. A lot of rising motion, lifting ahead of this. That's going to create the severe weather in the Southeast. On the back side of the system, cold air plunging down into the middle of the country. We'll see a lot of wind and a lot of blowing snow tomorrow. That's what it looks like at the surface. This is where we've seen the active weather today, the freezing rain and the snow. We've also seen a lot of wind and snow here in the high plains. We'll focus in on this area right here. This is our winter weather radar, and areas in orange indicate where we're seeing freezing rain or sleet, and there has been plenty of that tonight in northern Illinois. That could certainly cause some problems, so keep that in mind overnight and early tomorrow. Chicago area, northern Illinois, northern Indiana, and parts of Ohio. As we're looking for a mix in these areas through mid-morning tomorrow, then snow a little farther northward and rain a little farther to the south. In the southeast, we've seen some areas of rain and some thunderstorms in some spots tonight. Storms are now beginning to crop up here in Little Rock, eastern part of Arkansas, and they extend across Tennessee. It's been a wet night in Nashville and across 65, and we're finding more of the same towards Chattanooga in the eastern part of the state. Now, overnight, as the upper level low gets closer and closer, and we bring that upper forcing closer to the lower Mississippi Valley and start to tap into that deep Gulf moisture, the result we think is going to be the potential for severe weather in Louisiana and Mississippi, stronger storms a little farther east, and we'll move this area eastward through the day tomorrow, right about here towards Georgia and Mississippi, and I'll show you that in just a moment. We'll take you to the northwest now and into the west. This is the Arctic blast that's dropping down once again. It's not going to produce a whole lot of snow. We're talking about 1 to 3 inches in a large area, but that snow is going to be blowing around. Look at the winds here, 51 miles an hour, Rapid City. That can create very, very low visibility. That will make it very difficult to travel. And the other concern is the wind chill. 8 degrees below zero is your actual air temperature in Glasgow right now. Factoring that wind, feels like 52 degrees below zero. It's going to be dangerously cold across the northern plains through the day tomorrow. So there's your forecast. All comes together tomorrow. We'll watch the system grab up some Gulf moisture here, so severe weather breaks out again initially, we think, towards Louisiana and Mississippi, and that will travel eastward through the day. Now, because the winds will be coming from different directions at different heights, we call that wind shear, we could see tornadic storms developing. You take a pencil and you roll it between your hands, that sort of simulates shear between your two hands like that, and that's exactly what gets these storms rotating and eventually develops tornadoes, and we are concerned about that possibility tomorrow. It's going to be rain in the Ohio Valley and Mid-Atlantic region, and then on the back side of the storm here, snow will be blowing. It will be absolutely treacherous for travel and extremely cold. It is really going to be wild here. We also will see some snow and some rain in the Pacific Northwest, but most of the action here in the eastern half of the country. So there's how it looks for tomorrow. Strong storms in the southeast again initially here. Blizzard conditions in the northern plains, very windy, very, very cold, and the wind chills absolutely outrageous in the northern part of the country. 60 to 80 degrees below zero, North Dakota, South Dakota, down into Nebraska. Very dangerous indeed. We'll have more on Weather Center coming up. Stay tuned.
This program was sponsored by Allstate. You're in good hands with Allstate.
It cost me something, but it was the right thing to do. I told them, he's your son, but statistics don't lie. It's just not good for a teenager to have one of these super fast cars. Insurance is all about protection. Now, if I help put that kid behind the wheel of that car, who am I protecting? You're in good hands with Allstate. Mine.
To find an agent near you, contact 1-800-ALLSTATE or visit our website at allstate.com.
Happy birthday, Dad.
Hey, Campbell's tomato soup, huh?
You always knew Campbell's was good. You just didn't know how good tomatoes could be. Recent studies have shown that diets rich in tomato products are associated with a reduced risk of certain types of cancer. And all 8 Campbell's tomato soups are full of tomato goodness.
There's enough Campbell's here to last me 100 years.
That's the whole idea. Campbell's. Mm-mm good. Want a quick snack? Try Campbell's ready-to-serve tomato soup in the resealable container.
He's a powerful man, a rich man, a single man. But fate...
probably gonna want to buckle up, Jack.
...is about to show him the man he could have been.
Come on, Dad, get up!
What's happening to me?
This is a glimpse.
How did I get here?
This isn't my house.
What?
It's just two kids, right?
The Family Man.
Do you know why I work here?
Because you're the best damn tire guy in the state of New Jersey.
Rated PG-13 at theaters December 22nd.
Need extra cash for the holidays? Don't charge it on your credit cards. Get a second mortgage with no closing costs from DieTech.com. With a second mortgage, you can consolidate all your existing high-interest debts. Get the cash you need for the holidays and end up with one lower monthly payment. A second mortgage with no closing costs is smart money from DieTech.com. Log on now for fast online approval or call us at 1-800-71-FIX.
Your weather today, the best way to plan your day. Join Heather Tesh and Marshall Seek weekday mornings from 7 to 9 Eastern on the Weather Channel. The Weather Channel is brought to you by this cable or satellite provider. You can also get reliable forecasts from the Weather Channel through this newspaper.
Next week on Atmospheres, tracking twisters on the ground. Storm chasers capture killer tornadoes on tape. Plus, watch hurricane hunters in the air as they fly into the eye of a hurricane. And log on to weather.com/atmospheres to interact while you watch. Don't miss Atmospheres, a new hour-long magazine show hosted by meteorologists Jim Cantore and Mish Michaels, Wednesdays at 8 on the Weather Channel. You've never seen weather like this before.
Right now, it's your local forecast on the Weather Channel.
The weekend, and it's setting up to be a rough one with blizzard conditions forecast for the Midwest and also the threat of some tornadoes for the Southeast tomorrow. Good evening and welcome to Weather Center, sponsored by Lysol. I'm Lisa Mozer.
And I'm Dave Schwartz. I know who you are. I just wanted to let our viewers know.
They know who I am, too.
That's true. Hey, the forecast is coming up in just a minute. I want to set up what's going to be happening here, especially in the middle of the country. Here's a look at our current surface map, and you see all the L's. Look at all that. Low pressure. That means that air is being drawn into a developing storm. We'll see only one area of low pressure in the middle of the country tomorrow, and it is going to be a monster. Meanwhile, all the yellow, the fog, and the green, the rain, moisture is being drawn in. Over cold air, that's why we got the fog outside tonight, Interstate 20, Interstate 40, and 44. Meanwhile, on the north side of it, there's some light snow falling heading into the Twin Cities tonight. This is just the beginning. And then very cold air streaming southward. You can begin to see the big turn of a large area of low pressure that'll be setting up right here over the Mississippi River Valley tomorrow. Moisture is being sent eastward. Cold air is coming southward, and we end up with this. What a weekend! Boy, you work hard the weekend, and you're going to have to spend it all inside if you want to stay away from this windy and cold weather. Here on the East Coast, it'll be windy and warm, relatively speaking, at least warm enough for rain. Here we go. This is just the beginning. The pieces are all coming together. The rain in Tennessee, there have been flood warnings. here in Detroit. We've had a few sleet pellets and snow flurries. In Chicago, we've got some more freezing rain headed in, temperatures in the upper 20s across the metro area. This is all light precip, light snow and freezing drizzle now in Madison, snowing up toward Green Bay, 30 degrees. And there's the snow rotating around this one area of low pressure in Iowa, heading up toward the Twin Cities, while you can see the northwest push out here. Low pressure dragging a cold front through Imperial, Nebraska, wind gusting there to 54 miles per hour. And there's a lot more where that came from. Right now we're a mild 30 in Chicago, 24 in Des Moines. Enjoy this lovely warm night in Des Moines, because temperatures, while they're going up here ahead of the storm, are coming down here, and that cold front and low pressure moving rapidly to the east. We'll have your forecast coming up, but first, let's head south. Here's Lisa.
Let's take a look at what's going on, and don't be surprised if you head out right now in the Atlanta area and you see a number of accidents. Lisa, our evening producer, drives about 20 minutes from the Weather Channel and said that, hey, I've had